And there's great news here from the Heysel Stadium in Brussels, because 2 minutes of the first half have gone and Dundee are leading 1-0. The goal was scored after 50 seconds by the inside left Gilzean in Dundee's first attack, with the Anderlecht defence completely split open. Now here's Jurjen. But now, away come Dundee, playing in the dark shirts. This is Gilzean, the man who got the goal. Dundee slowing it down, they're getting at their own pace. Now up comes Highlands. To Janssen, and now here's the man to watch, the young Van Hintst, only 19 years of age. And a foul given against Dundee, given against Wishart. Van Hintst back to Jurjen. And back come the Dundee men to form this retreating defence, urging Anderlecht to carry the ball forward. As Hanon, Stockland moving forward quickly for a pass, and instead it goes out to Huys on his left wing. Speed off the mark, and again Slater there. Quite a lot of Penland's passes going astray. Now here's Smith. Away goes the right back, running into trouble. Gilzean there, number 10. Up Highlands. And a foul. No sliding tackle being penalised by Continental referees. So it's a free kick to Anderlecht. Being taken by the right half, Hanon. A line of Dundee players, eight of them back in a line. Now here comes Van Hintst. And the corner. This Anderlecht team has come a long way since it was beaten 10-0 by Manchester United in the European Cup of 1956-57. The fourth time they've been in the European Cup, and they hadn't even won a match before this season. It's Gordon Smith playing as an auxiliary right back. A Penman. Jurjen. Splendid player, perhaps a shot from him. But it's solid rock of Ewer, centre-half. 10 Dundee men back in defence. Janssens, and a goal kick. Game developing as nearly all European Cup ties develop, especially first legs. There is the home team going all out for goals, the visiting team defending and trying to keep the score down. And if of course they can do what Dundee have done, and let's get a goal in 50 seconds, so much the better. There's Huys. Neat one through to Van Hintst. That's a close return pass, but you're there. And they look forward to moving around very well indeed. Finding this Dundee defence a hard nut to crack. Penman sending Cousin away. And Cousin seems to have that centre-half for speed. Gilzean to Robertson to Gilzean. And that's two! That's two! Gilzean has done it again. Well, I know there were an awful lot of people at home who laughed at Dundee in the European Cup, but they've shown the way they got 8 goals against Cologne, then 4 against Sporting, and now after 18 minutes they are 2 up. Wishart, Robertson forward to Gilzean. Highlands anticipating that one beautifully. So Stockman, centre forward of Anderlecht now. Tripped by Smith. Very late tackle by McGay Gordon Smith. Who, of course, played for Hearts and Hibs in the European Cup. First and only man so far to have played for three different clubs in the European Cup. Hannon with the free kick for Anderlecht. That should be Slater's ball. Ooh, he wasn't keen about it. This must be a goal. Stop them. The penalty is equal. Penalty. Penalty and the Dundee boys, it was Cox saved on the line. The Dundee boys say he breasted it. So, well, I wouldn't like to say from here, but I should say that I had a better view from here than the referee had, who must have had about eight men between him and Cox. A most incredible decision, really, because he could never have seen any offence if there was one. Now, Lippens, the left half, and a score! So it's Dundee who start the second half. Dundee, who had such a magnificent first half, leading 2-1. Right, some people might not like these tactics, but they're perfect European Cup tactics. Now, certainly Anderlecht, a team of the class that would, well, certainly be at the top or near the top of the first division in England or Scotland, and yet Dundee have held them. Except for the sort of team that must be the big match team. There's the score. Gilzean 2 for Dundee. Lippens a penalty for Anderlecht. And it's a free kick to Dundee. And it's going to be number 3! Yes! It is number 3! It's scored by the centre-forward cousin. And believe it or not, he scored in the 50th second of the second half. And Gilzean scored in the 50th second of the first half. There's the score, 20 minutes to go. Gilzean 2 and Cousin for Dundee. Lippens a penalty for Anderlecht. Still this game, one of the finest European Cup ties I've ever seen. Certainly the cleanest European Cup tie I've ever seen. And a magnificent performance by both sides. Anderlecht continually on the attack, Dundee playing superbly in defence, and no one playing more superbly than Slater. A foul by Hyland on Cousin, free kick to Dundee. Taken by the left half, Wishart. Those are the ones that Anderlecht don't like, and it's going to be 4! It is! The scorer is Penman, but the man who made it again was Gilzean. 19 minutes left, 4-1. 15 minutes left to play as Wishart takes the free kick for Dundee. Still the odd thunder flash going in the crowd, but they must realise now that this match belongs to Dundee. And the poor goalkeeper getting an awful raspberry from the crowd now. Van Hibs to Johnson's. And is it a goal? No, it's Schnurr who saves it. I should say almost nothing will go into that Dundee net, but these boys deserve any of the luck that's going, because it's a wonderful pleasure to see a British team playing as Dundee are playing, every man giving 100% effort, fighting all the time, everybody working, moving forward in attack, coming back, doing a stint in defence, everyone playing their heart out. Slater playing the Continentals at their own game. Whistle. He sends Robertson away. Robertson now discarded his shin guards. Atu. Janssens. Van Hintz going on to the right wing. Trying to create a gap. Jurion. To Hanno. And a goal kick. And under 10 minutes left for play. In fact, only about 6 minutes left. Moving forward once again is Wishart, the left half. And now it's Dundee coming into the game as attackers. Remarkable to say they haven't been in the game as attackers when they got 4 goals, but that's the way it works. They fought a skillful tactical battle and they fought it superbly well. Now, Robertson moved to that one. Thank goodness he can. And it's going to be 5! Hendon, and it's a corner. And quite a number of the Anderlecht players not even bothering to come back in defence now, as Smith takes this corner for Dundee. His cousin. Jurion to Hanno, now forward to Janssens. Ooh, was that a foul by Ewer, a very late tackle, a very bad one that. That's the spirit in which this game has been played. Hanno with the free kick, entering the last minute now, 4-1 for Dundee. New aggregate of goals count, so whiz and a goal kick. Goal kick to Dundee. Only seconds left. And once again, the mickey taking by Dundee on their very fine opponents, Anderlecht. What really beats me is why Dundee don't play like this in their league matches. My goodness, what a team they are for the big occasion. It'll be a brave man who says they haven't got it in them to go on and win the European Cup after this performance. Their third superb one in the European Cup. Robertson back to Penman. And the whistle goes for the end of the game. Dundee have won a great victory by 4-1 over opponents who've shown themselves to be one of the greatest teams in Europe, but they've been beaten by a magnificent Dundee side, and the Scots are on the field mobbing Slater, the goalkeeper. The Scottish supporters have invaded the pitch and they're carrying him shoulder high to the applause of the crowd. Slater being carried off by the Scottish supporters, a wonderful sight. There he is, and how well Bert Slater deserved that applause, the whole stand rising to him. And so great news for British football. Dundee have won 4-1, a great victory.